2020 휴먼시티 디자인 워크숍 두 번째 강연은 미래의 인류와 창의적인 도시들이라는 주제로 루이사 콜리는
is of the future design and creative cities. It will be by Professor Luisa Colina. Let's have a look at the video.
Of the Human City Design Idea Workshop, dear students and colleagues, it's an honor and a pleasure to be with you, even if it's just for a few minutes, and to offer a contribute to the interesting workshop you are involved in. My name is Luisa Collina. I'm full professor of design at Politecnico di Milano in Italy, and I'm the dean of the School of Design, a school of approximately 4,000 students, all studying design in several different fields, from the more traditional ones of product design, communication design, interior design, and fashion design, to the more recent fields of the design discipline, such as service design and digital and interaction design. I have been also president for 6 years of Cumulus International Association, the network of design schools and universities that counts more than 340 members from 61 countries. 3 members are from South Korea. This short self-presentation is just to say that my roots are strongly in Milan, Italy, but my experiences, interests, and curiosities are highly international. And this is why I participate to this interesting workshop, bringing a recent experience developed in Milan, but that could offer food for thought worldwide. As you probably might know, Politecnico di Milano is one of the members of DISIS network, the network founded by Ezio Manzini, one of our professors, for sustainability and social innovation that counts several labs all over the world, including some labs in South Korea. Politecnico di Milano is also one of the partners of the European Human City Network, together with La Cité du Design in Saint-Étienne and other institutions representing different European human cities. Together, we have run several different projects since 2008, celebrating public spaces, reclaiming public spaces, challenging the city scale, and more recently, Smoothies, creative works with small and remote places. It's a cluster of research projects that explores from different points of views and in different ways the strong design energy expressed by citizens. In other words, how the inhabitants can be involved in reinventing city life, especially through experiments in the urban space, as a source of well-being and quality of life. For this and many other reasons, I'm particularly in tune with the contents of Human City Design Awards and with the related workshop. In the invitation letter, I have been nicely asked to give a speech about possible visions of new design for a new form of harmonious city design that can embrace people, society, and the environment. To contribute to the generation of these kind of visions is really important, and it's even more important today during this month of sanitary emergency. This is a very special moment for Milan and more in general for our community dealing with creativity and culture. The city just 1 year ago was full of energy, vital and in constant growing. It was a recognized capital in the field of design, fashion and culture. Nowadays, Milan shows its fragility and vulnerability. Ursula von der Leyen, the president of the EU Commission, a few days ago defined Milan as a beautiful, wounded city. All countries have been hit by the pandemic, but some countries have been hit sooner and harder, and Milan is one of these realities. For this reason, the municipality of Milan has dedicated almost 1 month in October to open a very broad and inclusive discussion among citizens regarding the future of Milan. The general title of the initiative was Fare Milano, Milan to be made, and it has been divided into 7 different topics: the city with its center and its suburbs, a healthy city, a city in need, the social needs of Milan, a city in environmental transition, smart and working, to be born, grow, and to live in Milan, a city that knows, creates, and educates. These have been considered the 7 pillars for the new start of Milan after the pandemic. And as you can see, many of these pillars are related to an idea of a new form of a harmonious city design that can embrace people, society, and the environment. The mayor and deputy mayor of Milan have asked to 7 different institutions, one for each pillar, to organize and activate the different processes of discussion. And I have been in charge for the last topic related to creativity. How did we organize the short and intensive activity? First of all, the activity has been organized in a combined way, combining top-down and bottom-up process. Top-down way, as the municipality has defined its 7 strategic pillars. Bottom-up way, as Politecnico di Milano could freely decide how to structure the debate regarding its pillar. Secondly, both the municipality and Politecnico shared the same interest in involving the younger generations and not just the present most powerful stakeholders. In order to collect fresh and new ideas regarding the future of the city and to look to a more extended time span. Thirdly, we have tried to structure the discussion in 7 different layers or subtopics in order to identify which were the main ingredients for a city that wants to keep its vitality in the field of creativity and culture. And we have tried to do it in a non-sectorial way. We didn't want to open several single discussions about the future of the publisher sector, the music sector, the theaters, the museums, the cinema and audiovisual sector, the design and fashion sector, the multimedia sector, and so on. But we were interested in organizing cross-sectorial discussions in order to get more interesting insights and visions. For this reason, we have identified 7 different cross-sectorial subtopics. To attract, to educate, and to promote future creative professionals, the schools, to give birth to new ideas, innovative services and startups, to create in the city new production models, to choose and to stay in Milan as a headquarter, the companies, to work in Milan, the new professionals, to involve and empower citizens and creative communities, to live in Milan, to design and to take care together of the common good. More than 70 persons have been involved in discussion and brainstorming activities during 5 intensive days. Which has been the main results? A city that is able to attract and to keep these different creative communities, starting from the young students, it's a lively city that invests carefully on its future. In order to attract them, a city has to be beautiful, open, inclusive, sustainable. It has to be an innovative ecosystem, able to offer interesting stimuli to the variety of its permanent and temporary inhabitants. It has to understand how to attract and keep each of its different creative layers, but also how to integrate them in order to facilitate process of contamination. It has to assure safety as well as to facilitate new relations among individuals and to increase diversity as a source for mutual understanding and innovation. Each creative and human city needs to design its new contemporary creative ecosystem, different from the past. In case of Milan, some interesting directions have been identified. Not just the idea of an independent, attractive city that competes worldwide with other international realities, but also the idea of a distributed city as a knot of a wide local network strictly connected with its close territories. Not just an oasis in the desert, but as an important fundamental fragment within a broader picture. Not just a resistant city able to overcome this difficult moment, but also a resilient city able to react in a flexible and an experimental way. Not just the beauty of the physical city, design often needs physicality, but also the necessity to integrate and extend its beauty and its contents in a broader way through a digital dimension. Not just an efficient city where nobody wastes time and resources, but also a sensible city, able to be inclusive of more fragile individuals, where individuals, young generations, but not only, can also waste a bit of time for reflecting and experiences. In this framework for the future human and creative cities, new sustainable ideas are needed in order to redesign our future everyday life. We need to redesign our health system, more in general, our possible 15-minute city with its streets and public spaces, services, transportation system, shops, museums, theaters, offices, enterprises and institutions, thinking to new rituals, new proximities, new ways of living, keeping the right distance. We have to go forward facing the major challenges in terms of sustainability, digitalization, and social inclusion. It's not easy, but it's time to work in this direction, all together. Thank you very much.
네, 미래의 창의 도시에 대한 다양한 시각을 보여주신 루이사 코디네.
On the creative cities of tomorrow. Thank you very much, Professor Luisa. So now we would like to wrap up the Human City Award Conference. I hope that you had a chance to reflect about the harmony between the humans and cities. And with that, we will wrap up the 2020 Human City Design Conference.